This week there was a story in the Daily Mail about Sussex University supposedly banning the use of the words he and she and incorporating non-gender specific language. I'm here at Sussex University to talk to Annie Pickering from the Student Union about what's going on. What's the story? What did you guys do that upset the Daily Mail so much?
So back in October, it went to our Student Union Council that it was a gender-neutral language policy, which advised that all students, among their activities, whether it's in a meeting or in student media, that we don't assume people's genders. So you don't automatically say he or she to someone. You use an impersonal one or a gender-neutral one, such as they. And then once you ask their pronoun, you stick to the pronoun that they've asked. So it was not banning any genders. You can use he and she and they as much as or as little as you like. It was just a question of encouraging and trying to be as inclusive as possible for people who maybe don't use he or she, and making sure that they felt included and it wasn't such a sort of sometimes awkward situation where they had to go up and tell someone, oh, that's not how I, prefer to be spoken to.
But a lot of the stress can actually be removed by using non-gender specific terms anyway, kind of. I mean, people say, good morning, sir, good morning, madam. You don't always need to actually put gender specific nouns into words, do you?
Our policy is really, it's up, for students to use how they wish, and it's students who brought it through, and I think it's probably fair to mention that we've got a group at Sussex called the Gender Liberation, which is a group of Sussex students who worked really hard to get this policy through. So we now have it within the Students' Union, and the ideal situation would be that it's used also within the university, so that when students apply and register as students, they can say which pronouns they prefer to use, which names they wish to use, so that it happens across campus and everyone can feel included.
But of course, this isn't the first time that the Daily Mail has actually twisted something that Sussex University Students' Union said. There was a story a few years ago because apparently you were going to force through having three different types of toilets, one for male, female, and transgenders.
I wasn't an officer when that happened, but yeah, our campus, we now have gender-neutral toilets. So they say gender-neutral and anyone can use them no matter what gender you are, as well as having male and female toilets on campus.
There is this great diversity. The diversity was always there, but a lot of people didn't have the language and didn't know what to do. I mean, I've got a very good friend who's non-binary, and they were saying until a few years ago, they didn't even know non-binary was a thing. They just knew that they didn't fit into the boxes that society was telling them to do. How actually do you think that society's changing and that bodies like the Student Union and the university need to be at the forefront of pushing this education and getting the message out there?
So as a Students' Union, we are run by students, and we're always really proud that students are at the forefront of social change, and it's them who are bringing these changes forward. So Gender Liberation Sussex said, we want, a policy whereby this happens, and so that we can use pronouns such as they, and it's not always, automatically assumed of your gender. So we're really proud to be a student union that is run by students, democratically approved and supported, to try and make, a better world at Sussex that we would like to see in the wider community.
Universities and students have always been at the forefront of political change and pushing supposedly radical ideas forwards. In the 60s, it was the peace movement and then gay liberation and this. Do you think that the gender barrier is the next one, the one that society is going to be facing and facing up to?
Potentially. For me, it has been such a change. I can admit that I wasn't such aware of it when I was a first year at Sussex, but it really has come to the forefront of at least quite a considerable amount of Sussex students, and it really is something that people care about, people are aware of, and yeah, I like to think that maybe progress is happening on this front.
This is Sophie Cook for latest TV news here in Brighton.